Hey to the Hyborian warriors, and to all fans of Conan, sword and sorcery and superheroes.
My first video on this channel was to warn people not to watch Kevin Smith's Masters of the Universe on Netflix, and so I made this video to reaffirm my thoughts about it. So, why do I make a video about He-Man? Before I became a Conan and sword and sorcery fan, I was already influenced in the early to mid 80s by the sword and sorcery genre and by a Conan derivative. And this derivative is He-Man and the Masters of the Universe. Naturally, like many young boys in the 80s, I have played with my He-Man figures and have watched the Filmation series of He-Man and the Masters of the Universe produced by Lou Scheimer. And to be honest, I still own many of these figures and have acquired new ones for videos that I plan to do in the future. What is the connection between Conan and He-Man? He-Man was developed by Mattel after the intention of producing Conan figures was made by Mattel, but Conan is not an IP for young children, even with the Conan the Barbarian comics. So Mattel has taken some ideas and archetypes from Conan, especially the ones of He-Man and Skeletor, and they have put forward these figures as toys for young boys after evaluating the Conan IP and the material for Conan the Barbarian movie. This has led Mattel to a legal dispute with the rights owners of the Conan IP, but the latter lost the case. Naturally, it was clearly a copy of Conan, but to be honest, one cannot own archetypes like the Herculean Hero or the Skull-Headed Evil Wizard. And He-Man and the Masters of the Universe and Conan are different enough to not be confused with each other. Nevertheless, it is still a fact that Conan and the paintings of Frank Frazetta, like the painting of Berserker or Conan the Conqueror, were always very close to the development of the IP. But this is not the case in the Filmation series. I will make a video on how these IPs are connected or share similarities in the future. The interesting thing is that He-Man and the Masters of the Universe was already destroyed as a money-making franchise in the mid-80s by making it into a girls' brand with She-Ra, the Princess of Power. And here, I would like to point to the Midnight's Edge channel that has made great videos about He-Man and the Masters of the Universe and how the IP has risen and fallen. And in light of this, I would cite this Bible text. What has been will be again, what has been done will be done again. There is nothing new under the sun. In similar manner, the boy franchises like Star Wars and the superhero genre were recently destroyed. And Conan in comics, as I have pointed out in my last video, will suffer a similar fate with many different means. The 80s and 2000X, He-Man and the Masters of the Universe are great entry points for young boys towards the sword and sorcery genre while being child-friendly at the same time. But this has been stolen from them by this Netflix series. And if we look around, then most of the boy franchises have been destroyed, diminished, and taken from boys away by the agenda, so that less and less true boys' things remain in the Western culture. It was not that there were not enough things for girls, it was alone the existence of these things for boys that was problematic for these people. Kevin Smith is one of these people who deliberately, together with Ted Biaselli, destroyed the He-Man and the Masters of the Universe IP once again with the same means by putting the female characters before the main male hero. And they do it again for the second time. The good thing is that people remember this and also how Kevin Smith lied about Clownfish TV. And that the interest in Netflix Kevin Smith's Masters of the Universe Revolution is also at its lowest, but this is mainly due to what they have done to He-Man and the rest of the characters with their agenda. What is negative is that this low interest in the IP can sustain forever, and I do not know if He-Man can have a comeback from this deep valley of interest. If we take the number of viewers from the trailers posted on YouTube, then we are around 110 to 120 of the interest that was there for the Masters of the Universe Revelation season. So this is a very deep decline in interest from the first season to the second. Naturally, there are fans who like Kevin's Masters of the Universe that should be rather called Mistress of the Universe, and other fans are so fanatic that you cannot ruin the IP for them. But overall, it seems to follow the development of Star Wars, and if this is so, then let us say that even Disney has given up on Star Wars. Therefore, let me repeat my message from over 2 years ago. Do not watch Kevin's Masters of the Universe. Do not give them your time nor money. And do not pollute your mind and neither that of your children with their agenda. Instead, you can watch the 2KX Young series here on YouTube for free, and perhaps the 80s Filmation series with your kids. I'm also already not giving my money to Netflix, and I will never do it because of the cuties. Due to the low views and high dislike ratio on the YouTube trailers of the Masters of the Universe Revolution, Mattel, Netflix, Ted Biaselli and Kevin Smith have realized that they have committed a mistake. And this is good. The owners of the IPs have to learn not to search for the modern audience, but to respect the audience that they already had. Give them what they want and not to spit them in the face. Because nobody deserves per se an audience, but the audience has to be earned with good work and investment into it. This was a short video just for the sake of keeping my continuity on Kevin Smith and his Masters of the Universe, and as a test on how fast I can make such a video. But I will return soon with more sword and sorcery. So for now, I will say to all true Hyborian warriors, Conan, sword and sorcery, and superhero fans, take care and hope to see you soon.